Good morning. Great way to start the morning off. We are so fortunate to have with us the composer of that piece, who's one of America's great composers. Steve Danyew is here. Steve, could you stand up? I can't really. There he is, right down here. He's having several works played here at the conference, and we're just so fortunate he takes an interest in the wind band. That was a piece about a train, if you didn't figure it out by the end, and really based on some experiences Steve had early on as a student in a jazz band when he was a young student. There was a certain lick they had to warm up on every day, and that he was telling me yesterday it kind of stuck with him, and that resulted in this piece, so we can thank a music educator for this piece. The next piece we're going to play for you is by a dear friend and wonderful composer, Julie Giroux. Julie is from, currently from Hollywood, but before that, she was at LSU and was a horn player. She happened to begin studying with Bill Conti, a famous Hollywood composer who wrote the score to Rocky, among other things. And that set her on a path of writing for film, video games lately, which is big business, and also for wind band and many other mediums. I think she's got over 30, maybe over 50 pieces for wind band. She's really paid attention to us, and we're lucky. This is a piece called Fields of Gold, and she imagines in this piece a young Superman who is growing up on a farm and beginning to realize that he may be a little different than everybody else. And he comes into his own in this piece, realizing the weight of being Superman and what that's going to mean for his life, but also how much he owes to his rural background, to his small town background. I thought it might be appropriate for us to be working on a piece like this. So this is Fields of Gold by Julie Giroux.
Thank you.
this next piece is by Frank Ticheli, someone who's actually here at the convention, doing the 5A Symphonic Band. His concert, I'm sure, is later today. This is a piece he wrote pretty recently, called Acadiana. Frank has done a whole series of Cajun folk songs. He's from Louisiana, but he went to high school here in Texas, in the Dallas area, and he's pretty much got his musical education in Texas before he went on to higher education. He's currently on the faculty of the University of Southern California, and he's written any number of pieces. One of the most prolific wind band composers out there. This is a piece dedicated to the victims of Katrina and in his home state. He's doing the third movement of this with his group, so we're doing the first and second this morning. So if you want to hear the rest of the story, you have to come back this afternoon. But the first movement kind of embodies the spirit of Louisiana, especially New Orleans, kind of a shuffle piece, shuffle jazz piece feel to it. The second movement actually depicts the event of the hurricane, and you'll hear how vividly he portrays that. And the last movement that you would hear if you come this afternoon is once again celebrating the spirit of the Louisiana people. So here's Acadiana, two movements by Frank Ticheli.
Thank you.
movements from a four movement work called the Steampunk Suite by Erika Svanoe. She's a young composer and conductor in the college ranks who has just come on the scene with this piece. It's such a great piece. For those of you who may know Robert Russell Bennett's Suite of Old American Dances, this is kind of a 21st century version of that in a way, all four movements. In her imagination, which is very vivid and rich, she imagines H.G. Wells in a flying machine in the second, the first movement we'll play. And then she imagines Tesla and P.T. Barnum riding on a bicycle built for two. So the old transportation meets the new transportation. Tesla, of course, is the Italian who, the Italians claim, my people, that we had invented electricity. Thomas Edison had something to do with that too, I think. But it's a great set of pieces. The second movement's kind of a mashup between Barnum and Bailey's favorite, famous march, and Bicycle Built for Two. And the students had never heard that tune, obviously. So I made sure we played it for them. I found a really nice example on YouTube of Dinah Shore singing Bicycle Built for Two. Funny they didn't know who Dinah Shore was either. I think the recording came from 1943 or something. So this is a fun piece and very nice music. A waltz, it's kind of back and forth between song and dance, which some people say are the only two options for composers. And so this kind of covers both. This is the third and fourth movement of the Steampunk Suite by Erika Svanoe.